Welcome to this guide where I'm going to show you how to install Windows 10 from a USB flash drive. Now before starting with the actual Windows 10 installation, there are a few things that we need to do first. The first one being Windows installation media. You need to create a Windows 10 bootable USB flash drive, and I've made a separate guide on that, which I'll link in the description of this video and in the cards now. The second one being, you need to make sure that you're installing Windows on the correct drive if you have more than one drive. Now, the easiest and most simplest way to ensure that you're installing Windows on the correct drive is by shutting down your computer and then physically unplugging any other drives that you have in your system and only leave the drive plugged in that you want to install Windows on. Now, if you can't physically disconnect any other drives for whatever reason, I'm going to show you another method that you can use. And that only works if your computer is currently working. What you'll need to do is open up your file explorer or this PC, and you should also see multiple drives like I have here. Now you need to identify the drive that you want to install Windows on. Let's say for instance I wanted to install Windows on this drive. Then I can just select it, right click on it, and then click on rename, and I'll rename this to delete me, and then press enter. And if you do get any prompts, just click on continue. And then that drive will be renamed to delete me. And that's how we'll be able to identify it when we're installing Windows. And you also need to make sure that you have backups of all the files that's saved on the drive where you're going to install Windows, as we're going to format it and all of the data will be destroyed. Now, when you're done and you have a bootable USB flash drive with Windows on it, and you're sure that you'll be able to install it on the correct drive, it's time to boot from the USB flash drive. So you can shut down your computer if it isn't powered off already, and then plug in the USB flash drive, preferably to a port directly on the motherboard. You can start up your computer and then immediately start hitting the escape, delete, or F2 keys on your keyboard repeatedly. You can start by hitting the escape key, and if that doesn't take you to your BIOS, you can restart your computer and then hit the delete key. And if that doesn't take you to your BIOS, restart again and then hit the F2 key. If you're still not taken into your BIOS, I suggest that you do a Google search for how to enter the BIOS on your specific motherboard. Once you've successfully entered the BIOS on your computer, you should see a screen similar to this if you have a desktop computer. If you have a laptop computer, it might look different, but the same principles still apply. In the BIOS, you can use the arrow keys on your keyboard to navigate. Or on newer computers, you'll also be able to use the mouse. Now, once you're in the BIOS, you want to navigate to settings related to the boot order. So on this specific Gigabyte motherboard, the boot options can be found in the BIOS tab. And here I have a few different boot options to choose from. By default, this should be set to boot from your SSD or hard drive, but we need to change that to boot from the bootable USB flash drive we created. So on this screen, I can press enter on the keyboard. And once I've done that, by using the arrow keys, I can change the boot option to the USB flash drive, which in this case is a 16 gig transient flash drive. Now you might also see two options, one being UEFI and the other just being the normal flash drive label. And this comes back to how you created the bootable USB flash drive in Rufus. If you chose the GPT partition scheme, you'll need to boot from the UEFI flash drive. And if you chose the MBR partition scheme, you'll need to boot from the normal flash drive label. But if you created an MBR bootable flash drive, you might not even see the UEFI option here. But in any case, if you have both of them available, just select the UEFI one first and then press enter on your keyboard. And then on the boot screen, you can also look for settings related to CSM support or storage boot option control. And first, just leave them on the defaults that they currently are on your system. But if you're having any trouble booting from the USB flash drive, come and change these two settings to the other available options as well. So once you've selected the USB flash drive as the first boot option, then you can go ahead to the Save and Exit tab in your BIOS. And once in the Save and Exit screen, you want to make sure to choose the Save and Exit Setup option and then press Enter on your keyboard. You'll be prompted to save the changes and you can just select Yes and then press Enter on the keyboard. Now, just another quick example of the same BIOS, but this time in easy mode. You should also see a boot sequence screen, and if you click on that, it'll open the boot sequence and list all of the drives. What you can do here is use your mouse to click and drag the boot device, which in this case is the USB flash drive. And then drag it up as the first boot option. Once you've done that, you can just press Enter or Escape to go back to the previous screen, and you can confirm that the USB flash drive is now the first boot option, and then you should also see a Save and Exit tab on the screen, and if you click on that, you'll see a prompt saying, "Are you sure?" and you can just click on Yes. Then your computer will restart and boot from the bootable USB flash drive with Windows on it, and then you can start with the Windows installation. Once your computer has successfully booted from the Windows 10 USB flash drive, you'll see this screen, and here you have three options that you need to check: the language that you want to install, the time and currency format, which is basically choosing the language and the country that you're living in, and then you can also choose your keyboard layout here. Once all of these settings are correct, you can click on Next, and then you can click on Install Now. Next, you'll be prompted to enter a Windows product key. In some cases, you won't even see the screen, and that'll happen when the Windows installation detects a Windows license key in the BIOS of your computer that's saved on the motherboard. But in case you see the screen and you don't have a Windows product key, you can select this option that says, "I don't have a product key." And then you can choose the version of Windows 10 that you want to install. Now, it's very important that you choose the correct version here. For instance, if you're reinstalling Windows and you had an activated copy of Windows 10 on your computer, you need to reinstall the same version as the activated version that you had on your computer. So if you had an activated copy of Windows 10 Home on your computer, you need to reinstall Windows 10 Home, or else Windows won't reactivate unless you enter a valid product key for the version that you installed. Another important note here is, if you do install Windows 10 Home and you have a Windows 10 Pro product key, you can activate the Windows 10 Home with the Windows 10 Pro product key, as the version will be upgraded from Windows 10 Home to Windows 10 Pro. But you can't install a Windows 10 Pro here and then activate it with a Windows 10 Home key. You can't downgrade the version from Pro to Home. You can only upgrade from Home to Pro. So make absolutely sure that you're choosing the correct version here before moving on. For this tutorial, I'm just going to go with Windows 10 Pro. And when you choose one of these versions, you always want to choose one without the N at the end. So I'm going to select Windows 10 Pro and then click on Next. Accept the license terms and then click on Next again. And when you get to this screen where you can choose between Upgrade or Custom, you need to choose Custom, Install Windows Only. And here on this next screen, you'll need to choose the drive where you want to install Windows 10 on. Now, earlier in the guide, I showed you that you can rename the drive that you want to install Windows on to Delete Me. And if you follow that step, you'll see one of these partitions labeled as Delete Me. For this tutorial's sake, let's just pretend that this local disk is called Delete Me. And what you want to take note of is the drive number of the partition that you renamed to Delete Me. So in this case, the Delete Me partition is on drive 1, and I also have another partition on drive 1 called partition 1, and then I have another drive which is drive 0. So that means I don't want to delete anything on drive 0, but I want to delete all of the partitions on drive 1. And like I said before, you need to make sure that you have backups of all the files on that drive, as we're going to format it and all of the data on it will be lost. So once you've identified the drive that you want to install Windows on, you can select it and then click on Delete. You'll be prompted that it contains important files. Go ahead and click on OK. And then you want to select any other partitions that you have on that drive number as well and click on Delete and then OK. And then you want to select the drive where you want to install Windows. In my case, I'm going to install it on drive 1. And before we move on, if you only have one drive physically connected to your computer, you'll only see one drive listed here, and you can delete all of the partitions on that drive and then select it. By the odd chance that you're not seeing any drives listed here and you're sure that there is a drive physically connected to your computer, it means that you'll need to load a driver for this Windows installation to detect your hard drive or SSD. And I've made a separate guide about that, which I'll link in the description of this video and in the cards now, that'll help you get that problem solved. But once you've selected the drive where you want to install Windows 10, you can just go ahead and click on Next, and then the Windows 10 installation will start. Now, this process can take anywhere from 30 minutes to about an hour, depending on if you have a solid state drive or hard drive in your computer. Now, once you get to the screen where it says Windows needs to restart to continue, you can click on Restart Now, or you can wait for it to restart automatically. But the most important thing to do here is when it restarts your computer, you can disconnect the USB flash drive from your computer to ensure that it boots from your hard drive or SSD and not from the USB flash drive again. And once it starts booting from the Windows 10 installation, you'll see the screen where it says Getting Ready or Getting Devices Ready. And in a few moments, we'll start by setting up the Windows 10 installation. Once your computer has restarted again and the Windows 10 installation is complete, we can start with the initial setup screens. And on this first screen, you'll need to choose your region. So you can go ahead and choose your country and then click on Yes. On the next screen, just choose the right keyboard layout and then click on Yes. If you want to add a second keyboard layout, you can do that by clicking on Add Layout, but I'm just going to skip that step. And if your computer is connected to the internet, it'll start downloading some updates. And you'll see this screen where it says, now we have some important setup to do. And you can just wait for Windows to install these updates. If you're not connected to the internet with a network cable, you'll be prompted to connect wirelessly. You can skip that step and just go ahead to the next screen. On this next screen, where you'll need to choose if you want to set it up for personal use or for an organization. If you select the setup for personal use option and you're connected to the internet, you'll need to sign in with a Microsoft account. But in the event that you are connected to the internet, but you want to use a local account instead, just choose the second option to set it up for an organization and then click on Next. And once you get to this screen where it wants you to sign in with a work or school Microsoft account, just click on this option that says Domain Join instead. And this will let you create a local account on the computer. So I'll just create an account called Memory and then click on Next. And I'll leave the password blank. If you want to use a password on your computer, go ahead and enter that there and then click on Next. Once you get to this screen where you need to choose the privacy settings for your device, I recommend that you turn off all of these sliders as you really don't need any of them running on your computer, and then click on Accept. Here you can customize your experience in Windows. I just skipped this completely. If you want to use Cortana, go ahead and click on Accept. I'm not going to be using Cortana, so I'll click on Not Now. And then once all of that is done, you'll be taken to your Windows 10 desktop. And congratulations, you now have Windows 10 installed on your computer. And I do hope this guide helped you out. Please like the video and then go ahead and watch any of my other helpful videos on this channel, some of which will teach you how to install drivers on Windows 10 and how to optimize it and set it up for the first time. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.